Park, diba? And then we kind of wanted to end the song na parang tanggap na ang sarili. That's why we have a line towards the end of the song that says, so, gotta face my fears, gotta face myself, embrace the imperfection that makes me nobody else. Wipe away the tears, look within yourself. Your reflection is more than an empty shell.
Which was actually the lines that she wrote. You wrote all of that, that last part.
Really? How about?
Yeah,
what part is that part? Wait, I'm looking at the lyrics now.
The last chorus.
The very last chorus.
It's like parang sudden twist.
Yes.
Repeat, but then there's a sudden reveal. That,
yes.
But maybe you started, figure it out. But when you were writing it, the first ano talaga lines that you wrote, mm-hmm. I mean, na lumabas, it's just the very
verse,
beginning.
The verse.
Just the other day when I saw your face.
Yes.
Magaling. So you're using the keyboards. I'm just curious, no? Paano siya nag sabay ba siya? O nag-chords ka muna? O yung lyrics mismo? Or sabay siya?
I think it was Dave kasi who started it also.
Yeah.
Sinabay mo?
Usually, how I'm able to write is just like fiddling around on the guitar or keyboard. It's either one of those. But if I want something like slow and senti or medyo ballad or something like chill, I'm usually at the keyboard. I can't write fast songs on the keyboard because I'm not a very good keyboard player. So ano lang, just very, very, very basic lang, diba? And then, ayun, just, I was at the keyboard messing around with like chord progressions and stuff like that. And then, once I play around with the chord progression that I like, and then, you know, just throwing out lyrics, basically
with
humming.
That concept
in mind. So, but that's usually how I start a song. Sometimes, like if I'm just walking or meditating, Marissa wants to do, she wants to collaborate with producers. Yeah. Other part of it also was like,
what
it
changed?
Was... Well, ayun, the pandemic.
In
the pandemic and and parang just getting
and
to know set. Each other more.
Yeah. Love.
Kasi even end of 2019,
mm-mm.
We sat down with her management and we're like, okay, this is what Marissa wants to do. She wants to collaborate with producers,
mm-mm.
songwriters. And I wasn't even talking about myself. Like, we were going to try and look for other songwriters and producers to collaborate with so that she could start building up a catalog of original music. And then biglang the pandemic happened. And then just everyone's worlds stopped and everyone just had to figure out, okay, how do we move forward? What do we do? And then, yeah, it started with Love You Still. But even that was, it was a very in the moment thing.
Mm-hmm.
It wasn't like, let's write a song. There was certain things that happened in that specific mm-hmm. moment. And the song just came na hindi namin pinano talaga. Na, for me personally, it wasn't like, okay, I want to write a song for Morissette. And there was actually a lot of people that were like encouraging me, oh, but hindi ka pa nagsusulat ng song for Morissette or ganto ganyan. And I was, I don't know. Like I said, insecurities.
Mm-hmm.
Kasi, syempre, I didn't, like, she's Asia's Phoenix. And then, I guess the other part of it also was, like, style-wise.
Yung mukha ni Morissette kung nakikita nyo, guys.
Parang, but like, even like, style-wise, diba? Parang,
hindi tayo the same, eh.
Oo nga, eh.
Yeah.
Kasi you're more into
hindi
alternative.
Eh.
And,
yeah. So, I didn't know how to, like, how was I gonna write a song for Morissette when music namin is like two different worlds, pretty
or
much.
Or so you think.
Which is what I thought nga, diba? So, ayun, kaya parang, that was one of the nice things that I personally liked about this whole process was because we didn't limit ourselves to like, okay, let's stick to like R&B or like, mm-hmm. I don't know, alternative or like rock or something like that, diba?
But I will have to say that like the kinds of genres that we put into the EP are based on my musical influences.
Yes. Yes.
It is based on those. So like example for Mirror, I think yung pinag natin dun was Jessie J, diba?
Mm-hmm.
Jessie J, Alicia Keys. It's like very like ganyan, very
yeah.
That feel.
Narrow,
so with and it's the same for the rest of the songs na dahil nga I've been singing or even my listening has changed throughout the years and I just like listening and singing different kinds of songs.
Mm-hmm.
We wanted to translate that into the EP na kung iba-ibang
from your musical influences.
My musical influences, like Beyonce, and the people would associate "Will You Stay" for that one naman.
Yeah.
And even for Phoenix, something na very anthemic. Kaya yun, parang yun siya.
So it was like, okay, let's not stick to one genre. Let's be creative and allow ourselves to just go wherever our creative minds takes us. And syempre, if it's sobrang layo naman, then we'll reel it back in. But if it's basically something that we could like slowly stem off of, then okay, let's go with the idea, diba?
Mm-hmm.
Na parang, okay, then at least after this EP, it won't be hard to go this direction or go that direction in terms of sound and songwriting. It's basically gonna allow us to continue to be as creative as we can. Because even like, as I've been writing for the past years, nabobored kasi ako pag isang ano lang eh, isang genre or isang tunog. Mm. So even, and I'll use it.
Mm-hmm. Of the EP, you mentioned many songs, different vibe and all that. But why did you choose Mirror Today to talk about?
Why I wanted to choose Mirror Today? I think because out of all of the songs, personally for me, out of all of the songs, I think it's a song that more people need to hear and be reminded of. Because, syempre, I mean, there's so many songs right now on the radio. People have their preferences. People like listen to music to escape sometimes, or just be healed, and just for anything. They go to music just for anything. But it's not all the time that you hear a song that's so true. Mm. Parang yung feeling ko, parang kailangan mo lang talaga marinig. And not a lot of people talk about it well. Not naman well, pero parang yung really, really talk about.
Yeah.
That topic, you know, like with Mirror, it's especially for the second verse. When we were writing the second verse for Mirror, Dave really asked me, "Oh, how do you want this to go?" And like, ako, when I remember when we were writing it, I would really go back to when I'd have those attacks. Na parang, I'm scared to be alone. I'm a stranger in my own, like,
home.
My own home, in my own comfortable place. Na parang feeling ko hindi ko nakilala sarili ko. I'm, ano yung sinanan? Scared to be alone. I'm a stranger in my home. I'm giving in to all the voices. Yung parang nagsusurrender na ako. And then the lines after that. Trying to be strong when all the lights are on. And what that really means is when I'm performing or when I'm out there stage, being, diba, when I'm a public figure, parang people expect you sometimes to just be okay all the time, when in reality, meron din kaming mga, or meron din tayo mga personal na mga pinagdadaanan na we don't really want to share with other people. And when we're out there, we don't want to think about them. But then, yun nga, when you go back to just being na ikaw lang mag-isa, there's really those moments na you get attacked by anxiety and just those fears. And so I guess I wanted to talk about that just because, you know, even ako, I don't know how to talk about what I'm going through with other people. So dinaan ko na lang po sa kanta. Parang ganun, na parang, and even for me, this song for me is also a reminder to me. Kasi even in the past couple of, ano, parang hindi naman nawala, I would still have those anxiety attacks. I would still be consumed by my fears and my thoughts and just overthinking. And so here's a song I feel na even ako, parang kailangan ko siyang pakinggan to remind myself na, okay, I have to face this, kaya to, of course, with the people around me, with the good people around me, with the Lord, with my friends, with my loved ones, supporters, diba? Kaya parang, I just feel like it's a song people need to be reminded of po talaga, bottom line.
I actually saw the music video. Ang ganda nga eh, no? By Jason Max, right?
Yes.
So how is it like shooting the video in this pandemic, like the materials? Ang ganda kasi ng setup and everything, no? The vibe of the music video. Can you share with us, like, how did it go? What, the concept? Well, it's Mirror naman, no? Pero, can you share with us yung, paano yung process yung ginawa?
Actually, what's nice po about it is, kasi sobrang extra lang po talaga ni Max. We call him Max. He's our creative director and a very good friend of ours na rin. But, and he also goes to Favorite Church with us. His wife is a pastor there, kaya all the same circle. Pero, we really love working with Max just because yun nga, he thinks of these, all these different concepts at the same time. Nagsisync kami, or we're on the same page now. We like symbolisms. We like putting subtle symbolisms. Pero actually po, yung, actually lyric video lang po talaga yun. Pero dahil extra si Max, ginawa niyang ala music video, ganun lang po talaga siyang tao. But working on that, I mean, I love the team. I love Max. I love sila Jonna. Sobrang chill lang din. Everyone's able to do anything.
Yeah.
Even when we're shooting the music video of Love You Still, like 7 lang tayo nun, mm-hmm. Diba?
Yeah.
7 lang tayo nagshoot nun in the middle of a pandemic, nakaya po namin yung yeah. Ganun. And everyone kasi is halos parang on the same generation, siguro. Mm-hmm. Same,
we're all the same age halos.
Same age, kaya parang same page lang talaga kami mag-isip mm-hmm. lahat. It was fun. With that lyric video or with that visualizer, we just really wanted to be creative. Kaya there's a yeah. lot of mirrors, may basagan ng mirror, may play of mirrors, arte-arte in front of a mirror, even a small compact powder mirror ginamit.
I'm curious, no? Kasi, like, because Dave is a very, ano, an amazing director also,
yes.
And a cinematographer. How come you didn't do the video?
Actually, Ate SL, I did the first two. I did Love You Still and Phoenix.
Napahinga ka na muna.
Oh, chill.
Yeah.
To all the listeners, no? Like, si Dave has been like, grabe yan, ang galing. Siya yung mga nag-shoot ng music video ko when I was no, nagsusolo artist ako when I was starting again as a solo artist. Guerrilla shoot kami, shotgun. Ang galing niya. Siya lang. Dalawa lang. Siya lang. At saka yung kapatid niya.
Yeah. Dalawa lang. Pleasant lang, surprises talaga.
Yung hindi mo pambato, kumbaga. Yun yung biglang, good reception.
Yes.
So, definitely. Before we wrap this up, why don't you invite everyone to listen to this amazing EP? Where can they find you? And where can they listen to your music?
My very first co-written and co-produced EP is out now. It is called Signature, featuring 5 tracks. Love You Still, Phoenix, Trophy, Will You Stay, and today's song in focus, which is A Mirror. And we also got more content on my YouTube channel din. Mga different lyric videos and music videos. And magpa-plug na rin po ako na I'm coming out with my 10th year anniversary concert. It's happening in January 23 and 24. It's called Phoenix. And I'm also gonna be producing. That's gonna be my very first production na magpa-produce po ako alongside being the performer. So,
and all the other music videos that you produced.
Yes, on top of all of that, we have a concert also. So, we're very, very excited. It's gonna be happening on KTX. So, sana people are gonna watch it. January pa naman, so may time pa mag-ipon, may time pa mag-Pasko. Pwede niyo rin siyang gawing Christmas gift, di ba? But yes, I'm just really happy with everyone's response for the music that we've put out, and it's just 5 songs for now. But I believe these are very parang solid songs, and we're so excited lang din to move forward. And even ako, hopefully my next decade into the industry, I'm happy to have started it this way, na parang kind of fresh. Na I'm getting into songwriting and producing, so it's also very new to me. But I'm really grateful for just everyone's support lang din po, and yun siya. And of course, sila Dave and the whole team, Underdog Music, and Miguel and Max and Sergio. Really grateful for everyone, and the Moinatics, most definitely. Thank you for your efforts. Yun lang po, and thank you po for having us. Thank you so much,
Ate Luis
and
Ate
SL.
Yay!